Community. Not only is the word community defined as a group of people living in the same locality, but used in different contexts is defined as sharing, participation, and fellowship. In both definitions, you can characterize a group of young men who not only reside in the same area, but also believe in an intense sense of camaraderie. A class of 32 senior student athletes shared a single vision, one of diligence, dedication, and success. These 32 individuals would share their singular dream to their extended athletic family of underclassmen. With the support of friends, family, and once again, community, they were able to focus on the tasks ahead by setting challenging goals and ultimately asking themselves, could this be the year? Would this be the year? To guide them on their journey of enlightenment, trusted mentors would teach them the intricacies of a game they loved, but also expose them to life lessons that would remain with them long after the final tick of the clock expired. Thus, the journey would now begin for the 2004 Gregory Portland Wildcats.
GP Varsity Cheerleader, and we're here at Buck Stadium for our first pre-district football game against the King Mustangs.
Go Wildcats!
Let's get it started in here.
On the base, keep running, 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 running.
In this context, there's no disrespect, so when I bust my rhyme, break your necks. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. You lose the inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl is pulling me out. You wouldn't believe how we wow shit out. We burn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from northwest east side.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stupid, get it started.
Control a body and soul. Don't move too fast, people just take it slow. Don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it, the P's will do it. Get started, get stupid. Don't worry about it, people will walk you through it step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we move it.
Yo, everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stupid, get started, get started.
Up inside your club or in your Bentley. Get messy, loud and sick. Your mind fast, no more than another head trip. Come down now, do not correct it. Let's get ignorant, let's get hectic.
Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked, get started.
Let's get it started.
Well, you told me you were trying.
Westport is. Both teams are undefeated, and we're going to kick some b**. Go
Race! paper, that other teams have made mistakes against us, and that's why we're where we are. Let me tell you why other teams make mistakes. They make mistakes because you out-hustle them, you outplay them, and you out-hit them. You are out-coached, they out-coach, and they're not ready to play. Nobody makes mistakes, we make people make mistakes.
Yeah.
We're playing not one quarter, not two quarters, not three quarters. Guys, it's time for four quarters of football. Woo. That's what we're gonna do. If it's going to be, up to me, Casey, if it's going to be, it's up to me. You're about to enter a lifetime memory. This game will be a lifetime memory. You'll be as old as me thinking about this game. Make it the best damn memory that you have ever had. If it's gonna be, it's up to me. Let's go!
Thank you.
rap. You come out ready to kill, baby. You smell blood defense. You smell it, black shirt.
You smell it, baby.
Let's go, boy.
Let's go, baby.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. No, baby, no.
Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Feel the rhythm of the music getting stronger. Don't you fight it till you try to do that conga.
Fly like an eagle, let my spirit
The top-ranked GP Wildcats has stormed past their first two playoff opponents, but the going gets tougher this weekend with Alamo Heights coming to town. It's payback time for the Cats. The entire city of Portland is buzzing about their Wildcats. An overflow crowd of 7,000 is expected for Saturday night's game against the Mules. There's nothing like home field advantage. Head coach George Harris doesn't doubt his team's ability, but with this being Thanksgiving week and all the distractions, the big thing he's worried about is a potential lack of focus. Well, the tickets are hard to come by for the game, but Alamo Heights is expected to return some of their tickets before the game. Plus, GP is considering adding bleachers on the visitor's side. All this begs the question, when will GP finally expand that stadium? Good news.
And the GP Wildcats are all geared up for tonight's game with Alamo Heights. Several hundred GP fans taking over the Portland HEB's parking lot for a pep rally this afternoon. Their Cats are still ranked number one. They're unbeaten, and this crowd is just a taste of what you'll see in the stands tonight.
This is a small tease. This is nobody compared to who's going to be there in the game. We already sold out all our tickets in 35 minutes, so there's going to be a lot of people.
It was a big game last year. They beat us last year. Like Coach said, we had a year to think about it. It's going to be a lot of revenge going on, and hopefully we can come out on top.
Now remember, if you want to see this game, standing room only are the only tickets left for tonight's 7:30 kickoff. We'll have all the highlights of that one, of course.
I'm Eleanor Rucker here at Wildcat Stadium for the regional semifinal game against the Alamo Heights Mules.
Yeehaw! played out just like we wanted. Our offensive line did a great job. We controlled the ball, we controlled the clock, and made Coach McKinney feel a lot better with that defense.
I would like to start by thanking the 2004 seniors for their hard work and dedication. This season will go down in Wildcat history as one of the greatest. This was GP's 22nd district championship, the first 10-0 season since 1994, and the 11th in school history. We also picked up our 31st victory over the Calhoun Wildcats. That should be some fond memories you take with you as you graduate and move on in life. You have added to the remarkable tradition of Wildcat football. There were some big games this season, none bigger than the Battle of the Bridge. The Wildcats got off to a great start, scored 25 points in the first half, and coasted to a 39-13 victory. Flower Bluff was our first important district game as both teams entered the game 4-0. Your commitment paid off for a 47-8 victory. Revenge played a big part in our 24-0 victory over Kingsville, a game in which our black shirts allowed only 4 first downs. Our goal was to go into the Cal Island game 9-0, and we did. A sold-out crowd watched as we battled 0-0 for almost 3 quarters before giving up a score. Behind 8-0, we weren't to be denied. A great fourth quarter comeback and a 15-8 victory for the district championship. On to the playoffs and some great victories. None sweeter than the 38-20 victory over Alamo Heights. Pflugerville Conley, 2 or 3 big plays, and we could have claimed the victory. What a great year, one you should have wonderful memories of. Seniors, the world lies before you. There are many opportunities. What you do, where you go, and what you become depend on your willingness to work toward a goal. A goal is nothing more than a dream with a time limit. As a Gregory Portman Wildcat, you learn the virtues of perseverance. You learn to overcome obstacles with proper effort and practice. If you pursue other goals throughout life with the same tenacity, you will succeed. More important, the key to success is within yourself. No one can give it to you or take it away from you. You hold your own destiny in your hands. Play every play of life just like you did this year. Play to win. Good luck. You certainly will be missed. As the torch is passed on to next year's seniors, it is burning brightly and gives us confidence. Our goal at Gregory Portman is to always be the best.
Big break in this ball game. In motion, give to Weed up the middle. He has a hole across the 40, 35-30, has running room. Connell's out with a block, 20-10. He's down at the 1 yard line. Justin Weed with a super run to open the ball game and stun these Cougars of Pflugerville. Wide receiver right, man in motion. Weed up the middle, touchdown. Justin Weed, 1 yard touchdown run, 2 plays. And the Conley faithful are shocked. There's a snap, the hold, the kick, it's up, and it's right through the middle. Actually, it's on the roof.
As the year began, there was every indication that something special characterized the crew of senior-led athletes for the Gregory Portman Wildcat football team. to what degree this something special was is not initially clear and defined. In time, it would be quite apparent to not only the communities of Gregory and Portland, but all of the Coastal Bend, and ultimately the entire state, that the 2004 Wildcats team was a member of the most talented, dedicated, and supported upper echelon programs in all of Texas. The fine coaches and athletes committed themselves to maximizing their effort on a quest for the state championship, but unfortunately would fall so desperately close to their goal. During the impressive run, the overwhelming encouragement and generosity from an adoring community knew no bounds. They traveled wherever the schedule directed them to and tried to make every game, regardless of the locale, have the atmosphere of a home game at Wildcat Stadium. The 2004 season will be noted for exemplary performances. For each individual highlight and record set, the entire offensive or defensive units would share in these collective successes. For the Wildcats, the efforts of the many attributed to the accomplishments of the one. Congratulations to the Wildcats, the players, the coaches, and the community. Together, you share a year that will not soon be forgotten.